G'day and welcome back to Build Some. And in today's video, what I want to show you is how we calculate the drop-off on our roof. So basically what the drop-off is, if I zoom in here, it is the distance down from the top plate to where it would be level with the end of our rafters. So it's this distance here, formed by this yellow triangle. So from the top of the plate down to a point that's level with the bottom of our rafter. Okay, so that's the drop-off. Now, the common uses for the drop-off, one is to give us a point for our bricklayer to lay their bricks to. Now, that would generally have to be 10, 15 mil lower than our drop-off because we have to keep a distance or a clearance between our eave and our brickwork if we had level eaves. And the other reason that we'd use it is so that we could locate where the top of the windows would have to finish if we were going to run our eave in flush over the top of the windows. So we need to work out how to calculate our drop-off. So it's reasonably easy. We need to know a couple of things. The formula is tan times the roof pitch, and then we times that by the eave's width. Okay, so in this case, our roof pitch is 30 degrees, the angle here, and our eave's width is 300 mil from the brickwork to the outside of the rafter. However, because this is a brick veneer example, we need to add 110 mil for our brick and 40 mil for our cavity. So that'll give us a total of 450 mil for our eave's width. Okay. So there's the formula there. 1030 times 450 mil. And as I said before, 300 plus 110 plus 40 gives us the 450. So the answer to that is 0.2598. So let's say 260 mil is our drop-off. Now this is a trussed roof and we don't have any bird's mouth. However, if we were to have a bird's mouth, then you can see that there's a distance here from where our triangle finishes to the top of the plate, and we need to accommodate, or we need to add that distance into it if we have a traditionally cut roof with a bird's mouth. So the first step is exactly the same. We've worked out that it's 260 mil from here to here. All we have to do is add that remaining bird's mouth in. Now, quite easy to measure that distance, or it could be given to you. However, some cruel sadistic people use a method called horizontal bearing, and what they do is they give you this distance here. Now, I don't know why they would, but it happens in some examples, so I'm going to show it to you. So basically, all that is, if you have a look at that, if we take that little triangle there, that's just a smaller version of this triangle here. So the same formula applies. So if you go down 1030 times 24 mil, that actually gives us 13.86, so let's say 14 mil height or distance here, 14 mil. So all we have to add is, all we have to do is add 260 mil and 14, that gives us 274 mil as our drop-off in this example. So there you go, there's how we work out the drop-off for both a truss and a conventionally cut roof with a bird's mouth.